Hi everyone, Kim Schofield here. Welcome to another video on my YouTube channel. Today I have a fun project for you featuring some new products from Joggles. These have been out for a little while, but they are new to me. They are wooden shrines and they are so much fun. So I created a project here as you saw right before we got onto the video. So this is the one that I am using and this is how these come. So they come apart. You have four pieces where you're going to put together your frame. And here's just a few other ones that I have too. Here's a real small one with the foot, which is really fun. And then here's a little bit larger one with that sunburst, although the inside frame part is the same. So I just grabbed some decorative papers. These are from Authentique. You could certainly use anything. But the first thing we're going to talk about is how to put this little frame together. And I am using some gel medium from the Crafters Workshop, but you could use any kind of strong white glue. This gel medium is awesome. It holds really, really well. And I am just applying the glue to all the four sides there with the indent. And then I'll just insert the tabs into the indented area. This is pretty simple to do. And then to hold everything together, you can use a piece of tape. I actually started out with some painter's tape that I put along the edges just to hold those seams closed. And then I'm also going to go ahead and put a rubber band around the whole frame, and which got a little wonky there. I wasn't quite sure how to do it, but managed to get the rubber band around, and I let that sit and dry overnight. So I removed the tape and I left that overnight to completely dry. And so now I am going to apply some vintage book text onto the wings, and I ended up covering the whole thing with this. And again, I'm just using some gel medium. Now, because this is vintage book text, it tears really easily. It's very delicate paper. And so I'm able to just go around the shape and tear this out. And then any areas that didn't get torn, I'm just using my scissors to cut around that. And then I have a file here that I'm using that I'm gonna file down all of the edges so that any excess paper hanging over will be gone. So now I'm gonna go ahead and my box is completely dry and I'm gonna go ahead and add some more decorative paper to all of the edges. So all I did was measure the sides and then I just cut my decorative paper to that size. And now when you're putting the paper on the inside, you'll probably have to trim just a little bit just to make sure that it fits because it'll be a little bit smaller. But this was super easy to do. And then when I had any excess glue, I actually ran my finger around the edge and that kind of helped to hold that all on. And then again, using my file to file off any extra, just because you don't, you know, always cut exactly perfectly. Sometimes you have a little excess, and so I just use the file, and that removes that paper really easily. So I'm covering all the sides, the inside and the outside, and I did actually even cut very thin strips of paper to cover the very front of the box, and this will act like a shadow box when it gets attached onto the base with the wings. And this gel medium sets up pretty quickly. So once I got the paper on and let it sit for a few minutes, I could really keep on creating. So I'll just apply my little strips there. And again, I just measured those and cut them to size. This is a 4x6 box. So you just have to measure how wide or how deep it is. So here, my piece is finished now, and I wanna knock this text back a little bit. It's a little too stark for me. And so all I've done is taken some gesso, watered it down, and I'm just applying that on top of the text. And this is from a book. I don't know, it's some kind of crazy story. So sometimes when I read the words, I think I don't want people to see these words. I don't even know what this book is, you know, that I pulled these pages out of. So some of it's a little, makes me laugh when I see some of the words. So just adding another layer, and you'll want to make sure you dry this completely before you go on to doing anything else. So now I have this a stencil from Joggles, and I'll have links to everything in the description below. And I'm using some embossing paste. Wendy Vecchi's is my favorite. And applying that with a palette knife just onto the wing portion. So I just wanted my wings to have a little bit of dimension. And then I'm just going to clean that up. And any excess you have on the edge of your wings, you can just go ahead and use your palette knife and remove that extra embossing paste. And then I'll go ahead and do the other side. And this is a very light modeling paste, not modeling paste, embossing, embossing paste. So it dries really quickly and you can mix it with all kinds of other mediums, which I'm going to do, of course. Okay, so now I have some acrylic paint. This happens to be from Paper Artsy, but you could use any brand. And I'm using some Liquitex glazing gel, and I'm using about the same amount paint to glazing gel. My ratio is the same there, and I'm going to mix that all up, and then I am going to apply it over the entire background. So I'm really working to get into all the crevices where the embossing paste has dried. And then also on the back, and I've kind of found this new technique doing this over the text. I love the way this looks when I start pulling everything off. I'm gonna have to try it again on a different project. So I'm gonna set this aside. I'm gonna let that sit on there kind of as long as it takes me to clean off my work surface. So maybe 20 seconds, 30 seconds, not too long. So you don't want it to dry completely, but the glazing medium will slow down the drying process. And then I'm going to come in with a baby wipe and remove some of that paint. And so you'll have to scrub a little bit where you have that texture from the embossing paste, because you'll want to get in, in between the crevices there. And so anytime you just want to keep going back and forth with a baby wipe, you kind of use it up, use one up, and then go and get a clean one. And that'll remove a little bit more of the paint. And then you just keep doing that until you kind of get the look that you're going for. But I loved the background. It kind of looked like this aged painted wood or something when I was finished. I kind of wish I'd done it over the whole thing. I'll just have to make another one because I love the look of that up towards the top there with that text showing through. So now, because I have to add brown to the edges of everything, but also because the paper has a little bit of that brown in it, I am using some archival ink. This is also from Wendy Vecchi, and just applying that along the edges, sponging a little bit across the top, just trying to make it match that paper a little bit better. And I'm using archival because I'm going over a painted surface, so distress ink will have a tendency to react with any kind of moisture, so I don't want that to happen. And so now I am ready to attach my entire frame onto my base, again, using that gel medium. And this, I put some heavy stuff on and I let that dry for quite a while again. So now I have a whole bunch of tchotchkes, just a bunch of stuff I have in my stash. These are some Tim Holtz paper dolls. I love them. So I pulled out two boys and a mom and a dad, so kind of like myself and my two children and my husband. And I have some other Tim Holtz tchotchkes, little bottles, flowers, some stuff from Prima. So basically you kind of pull out some things that you think you want to use and in your shadow box and then kind of end up seeing what fits. So I'm going to pop all of these little paper dolls up off the background. But to start with, I wanted to show you how you can use Wendy Vecchi's enamel accents to color. I'm adding some blue onto my wooden block here because this really helps that number four really stand out. And this, when it dries, it'll be a very shiny surface. Looks really cool. Looks like enamel. And so this is pretty thin. It's not a heavy product. And so it comes out and it's really easy to apply on top of surfaces. So I'm going to do the same thing with a little heart. These are matte minis from Wendy Vecchi and the two little butterflies. And because I'm putting a pretty generous layer of the enamel accents onto the matte minis, I did let these sit overnight. You probably wouldn't have to go that long. You might want to give them an hour. They dry to the touch fairly quickly, but then if you apply any pressure, it will kind of sink into the enamel accents before it's completely dry. And then once it's dry, it's very hard and it's got a high gloss to it. You can also see in the upper left-hand corner how I have some foam tape on the back of my little paper dolls. A bunch of different layers there. I added some little confetti into the tiny bottle, some little star confetti. You can see the foam tape, so I have one layer there and then a whole, but like five layers on one and eight layers on another. And this is so I can get some really good dimension. So I've added my block and one of my little boys and the mom and the dad there. And then I did trim off their feet a little bit because I want my other little boy, his hand to be resting on top of that little bottle. And so now you can see I am almost done. I've got all my pieces just put in here with the gel medium. You can see that great texture that I get and dimension. And now I'm gonna finish up my last little decorative pieces. I'm putting this little heart inside the metal clock face, I guess it is. And any gel medium you get that kind of spoogies out the side, that will dry clear, so you don't have to worry about that. And I also want to say that it held the key that I have in the front of my shadow box just leaning there amazingly well. I left it overnight, and man, it's like cemented in there. It did really well. So this, I love this gel medium. You could use a matte medium from Ranger as well. Attaching my little butterflies there. And I am just about done. I'm going to add a few stickers from a Tim Holtz Chit Chat stickers so you can see a close-up view there. This was such a fun project to create. I hope you check out these shrines and visit the Joggles blog for more photos and details. Thanks so much. Happy crafting.